farming is going to destroy agricultural productivity, right? That's what we keep hearing.
These are scientists and researchers you don't often hear from, even though their ranks are growing.
In the last 18 years, there hasn't been even a slight rise in temperature.
The predictions on which this scare was founded are incorrect.
This conference, put on by the nonprofit Heartland Institute, brought together some of the world's leading climate skeptics. Their message: don't believe all the scary warnings about climate change.
100 years ago or 200 years ago, out of every 10,000 molecules in the atmosphere, three of them, only three out of 10,000, were carbon dioxide. Now, after 100 or 200 years of carbon dioxide emissions, four out of 10,000 are carbon dioxide. There's very little carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
It is not widely publicized, but the Earth's temperature has been flat for the past two decades. In the absence of warming, climate alarmists started making new claims. Extreme weather events, they say, are proof of man-made climate change.
We have record low burnage as far as acreage. Yet if a wildfire occurs, people are going to say, look at that, wildfires or tornadoes. The fact that the total global hurricane activity, tropical activity, has plummeted the way it has.
Then they say droughts are caused by global warming and flooding is caused by global warming. So what isn't caused by global warming? This is not an intelligent conversation. It is just totally contrived, opportunistic sensationalism trying to make people afraid of everything.
There's no doubt about who is public enemy number one to these scientists. Al Gore's An Inconvenient Truth was filled with frightening predictions.
He sort of led the way, saying things which none of the scientists believe, like severe weather is getting worse, droughts are getting worse, floods are getting worse because of mankind.
The Arctic ice was supposed to melt away. Mountains would be without snow. Entire islands would vanish. Polar bears would be extinct. But even if the science is suspect, some on the left still use climate change to bash Western civilization.
Of course, there is an anti-capitalist agenda. You see this in the statements of so many of the small group, it's a very small group of scientists driving this scare. And you see time and time again in their statements a hatred of prosperity, independence. They don't like any free-thinking people.
Then there's now huge money in it. Academia gets $2.7 billion a year in this country alone and really all over the world. So it's mostly politics and money.
Much of that money goes to subsidize so-called renewable energy sources. Activists envision a world in which solar panels and wind farms replace oil refineries.
Solar is absolutely trivial. It's far less than 1% of global energy. After 20 years of subsidy, governments, companies, NGOs promoting it. So it really is trivial in the overall energy situation.
The sun doesn't shine all the time, nor does the wind consistently blow. And so if we're thinking about having energy sources that maintain reliability, it's important to have energy sources that can provide energy all the time.
If we actually stopped using oil tomorrow, half the human population would be dead within a short period of time, and there wouldn't be a tree left on this planet because everybody would use it for energy to cook and heat.
These skeptics may be winning the scientific battle, at least based on the evidence. But the larger war goes on.
We'll be fighting a fear forever. The battle is never won. To me, it's a battle of good versus evil. It's that simple, and we'll never win it. We'll just have to fight it forever.
To think that the worst scientific mistake of all time has occurred in my lifetime, and I'm a scientist, is very distressing. And it's certainly my goal and what's left of my life to battle it with all I've got.